Today we'll be doing some colour mixing using acrylic paint and primary colours, and I'll show you how to lighten colours up and also darken colours up and mix secondary colours. So if we come and have a look at the palettes, I've kept it really simple. We won't be using the black just yet, we'll just be using the primary colours and the white. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with a set of brushes. Today we're going to mostly use a flat brush, but there's also a filbert brush, and you can tell by the shape, the sort of tongue-like shape, and then we've got a synthetic pointed round brush. But for now, we're just going to be using this brush. So first of all, just taking the yellow, we'll show you how resonant and bright these colours can be. So we should just take the yellow into our palette, and then you can just see how it looks on the canvas paper, just up here. Can you see how bright that is? Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tint it. I tint it by adding, cleaning the brush, wiping the brush all the time, always have a tissue here, and then tinting a little bit of white into there, and then placing it, just to show you how you can lighten a colour up. And I'm going to tint it some more, again, wipe the brush, take a bit more colour in, so you're really lightening it. And you can see against that paper how light you can actually get it. Okay, and you can even use a pure white and take it there and blend it in. So the lovely thing about acrylics, they're quite viscous and thick, and you can really go for it. Now I'm going to show you, you can do that with all the primary colours along the top, but I'm going to show you now, in a moment, how to mix secondary colours. Could you stop it there, please? Okay, as you can see, I've done my three primary colours. Now I'm going to mix a secondary colour. So I'm going to go for a green. I'm going to start off with the green. I'm going to start off with the yellow, because traditionally yellow can dirty up very quickly and go a bit off and muddy. So I'm going to start off with the yellow, and I'm going to slowly add, going cleaning the brush, wiping it, slowly add a little bit of blue, and you can see how powerful the blue is. So I've mixed a sort of a mid-green, and I'm going to play it next to. Okay, and I'm going to start, I could go down a direction of lightening it up, but I'm going to show you how you can get different types of green. So I'm going to have a bluey green. Okay, so that's mostly blue and just a little bit of yellow. A bluey green, a nice deep bluey green. And I'm going to go for a yellowy green. And for the yellowy green, I'm going to actually use a slightly different part here, and I'm just going to include a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of the blue, so it's a really light, light, light yellowy green. A bit more. Okay. Now I'm going to show you with those colours how you can actually mix a browny colour. Now, if you take a secondary colour and then include another secondary colour in it, so let's say an orange, so I'm going to mix an orange. Again, the two colours here. A yellow and red. I'm going to mix an orange. I'm speeding up a bit now. Then I'm going to add it to the green, and you'll see it creates a lovely kind of browny colour, browny grey, depending on how much you use. And we'll apply it, and we'll just put it here, because that's a tertiary colour. And you can see it's the colour that you might get in a tree. And you can also dip a bit more white into that and pale it down and make it more kind of cool. It cools things down. If you want to cool the colour down and make it more grey, you put a bit more blue in. If you want to lighten it up, you can do a bit of white. So you can mix a massive variety of colours. Notice we're not using any black yet. I'm deliberately not putting any black in this particular session. That will come later on. Okay, that's it. Next stage, we're going to look at a Van Gogh and a Matisse. We're going to start off with a Van Gogh and try and emulate some of the greens that he's got in his trees. So if we go to the palette again, you can see how he uses much thicker paint, and I'm going to mix some nice strong, rich, thick paint here and have a go at adding. Okay, so if I go over to my, I'm going to have a look at the way he's using marks, thicker textured marks, and I'm going to keep going to my palette and keep pulling out some of these colours of different strengths of green. Okay, some of them lighter, some of them darker, some of them more bluey. Okay, and I'm just following the shape and texture. This is called impasto painting. It's thick paint on a surface, and you can actually start mixing the colour without actually mixing it on the palette. You can start mixing on the actual piece. Okay, and that's what Van Gogh did when he created his painting. If we go over to Matisse and have a go at trying a Matisse effect, you can see how he used purples. So I'm going to mix a bit of purple, some nice strong purple, light purple, and you can see how he used different brush marks. He exaggerated shapes and colours, so that's just using red and blue. And then I'm going to bring some more blue in, so it's darker, and I'm going to outline areas, and you can see how he outlines shapes. And he might bring in some pure red as well, so literally pure red into the surface, so he'll get some much stronger shapes and colours. And then he'll offset it with some bright, strong blues. And you'll get a real sense of life and vibrancy. So as you can see, there's different sorts of marks to be made, different sorts of colours to be mixed, and it's all in there in the Matisse and the Van Gogh. So have a go of that yourself, and I think you'll have learnt the first stage of acrylic painting.